A few thoughts now on President Trump rolling back the madness of Barack Obama and the left. At the same point in Mr. Obama's presidency, he was jet-setting around the globe on his infamous apology tour, apologizing to France and to Europe, claiming the United States had been arrogant in our foreign policy. Trump, he's been more productively engaged. While Obama was apologizing to the Muslim world, stating it was his responsibility as president, this is actually what a president of the United States said: to fight against negative stereotypes of Islam. That was President Obama's big number one priority. Well, 4 years later, Obama's red line failure assured the now current crisis and worsening crisis in Syria, that is worsening until President Trump and Vladimir Putin got together today. President Obama's inaction paved the way for Putin to take Crimea and to later invade eastern Ukraine. Thankfully, Mr. Obama is irrelevant today. It has a reassuring sound, doesn't it? Obama is irrelevant. Let's hope so. His failed legacy is being methodically dismantled by President Trump while he leads the free world. Mr. Trump is replacing Obama's policy of appeasement and passivity with a doctrine of American exceptionalism and a defense of Western values, of Western civilization itself. President Trump set the tone for today's meeting with Putin, calling on Russia to cease its destabilizing activities in Ukraine, to end its support for hostile governments in Syria and Iran. Today, President Trump comes away with a deal reaching a Syria ceasefire agreement. A Wall Street Journal op-ed defined Mr. Trump's governing philosophy this way, quote, "Mr. Trump is taking a clear stand against the kind of gauzy globalism and vague multiculturalism represented by the worldview of, say, Barack Obama, and most contemporary Western intellectuals who are willing, even eager, to concede the argument to critics of the West traditions. President Trump certainly is not among them." Trump emerged from this summit as the true leader of the free world. He's now lifting two continents at once, ours and Europe's, and putting Putin, Merkel, Macron, and the rest of the G20 in their place. And oh yes, in so doing, he has put Mr. Obama in his place as well.